Are you struggling to keep your Gmail inbox under control? Well, in this video, I'm sharing 7 proven tips to reach inbox zero and stay there. And be sure to watch to the very end because I have some Gmail shortcuts you don't want to miss. Hello, everyone. Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. So tip number one has to do with making use of effective labels. Now, often we view labels here within Gmail as a type of folder, and that's one way of thinking about it. For example, I've got a label here called Action Required, where I can put specific emails and then just go and focus on these particular messages. But labels are actually a lot more powerful than folders because you don't have to necessarily move things from your inbox. You can make the messages and the emails that you see here that much more relevant. So, for example, maybe there is a couple of emails here that I want to address a little later on. I'm going to select these 3. If I come up to the very top, you might be prone to moving those emails somewhere else. But let's be honest, sometimes when we move things over here, they either get lost or we simply forget to go back and check on them. Well, to the right is actually the labels icon. And by selecting this, I can say that, yes, I want to apply the action required label. You can actually apply multiple labels at once if you like, and I'm going to select apply. Now, those emails stand out. Even if I deselect them here from the top, those emails really stand out, and I can zero in on the messages that I like. And when I want to address one of these emails, let me open up this message here. Once I've either downloaded or read or replied to this message, I can come up to the top and quickly remove that label just by selecting this X, and now it's gone back to a regular message. But let's continue with tip number 2, because we actually haven't removed anything from our inbox yet. We've only made a few messages that much easier to read. Tip number 2 is all about using the snooze feature, which can be a great way to quickly tame your inbox and reduce the number of messages that are staring back at you. Now, here from your inbox, you can snooze any message without even having to open it. So maybe I'm excited to read about these updates. I just don't want to do it now, and I don't want this message cluttering everything else that I'm looking at. So I'm going to come over here to the right-hand side. I'm going to select snooze, and it's going to give me the option. How far in advance do I want to snooze this message? Now, for those who may not be familiar with the snooze functionality, whatever date I select in the future, it is going to immediately remove it here from my inbox, keep it in a bit of a holding pattern, and then return it to the top of my inbox depending on the date and time that I select. Now, we have a couple of defaults here: later today, tomorrow, this weekend, and next week. I find that 9 times out of 10, I'm selecting one of these 4 options, but if I want to push it out even further or pick a particular date and time, I can come down to the bottom, select this, I get a full calendar, I can change the date, I can change the time, and then select save. Now, where does it go? It's gone from my inbox. What if I do want to address that message before it automatically returns to me? Well, here on the left-hand side, you can see that we can go into our snoozed area. So this is going to show all of the messages which you have snoozed. And on the right-hand side, you can see that it's given a bit of an orange colored date. That's telling us when it is expected to come back to our inbox. Now, we can change that here. If we come over and select that snooze icon, we can not only change the snooze time if we want, but we can also unsnooze it, which will send it directly back to our inbox. Now, just before we continue, I want to remind you, if you're looking for ways to simplify your day and get organized with Google, why not subscribe right here to the Simpletivity channel? Each week, I bring you new tips so you can get more out of Google Apps and other Google-friendly products. So click subscribe below so you can take advantage of a more simplified day. Now, speaking of keeping our inbox clean and removing unwanted messages, you're going to want to make sure that you take advantage of tip number 3, and that is archiving your messages. Now, my rule of thumb is that whenever I have finished replying to a message or reading a message and getting the information that I need from it, I hit the archive button because I don't want it to remain here within my inbox. If you're in the habit of replying or reading and allowing read messages to stay here in your inbox, you are bound to let something slip or just make things look that much more chaotic as you're trying to determine, do I still need to come back to this message even though it's been read? Do I need to open it up that many more times than necessary? But if we archive our messages, we can still go back and find them. We can retrieve them whenever we like. So, for example, I'm going to open up this message again, and let's say that I have just finished replying to it. As soon as I'm done, I'm going to select archive. It is removed from my inbox, but it's not gone for good. If we come over here on the left-hand side and select more, and then come down to all mail, we will find all of our messages, including those in the inbox, but also those that have been archived. And when you go to search for a message at the top, it will always search through your archive and all mail messages as well. So this is a great way to keep things nice and clean. And another great way to take advantage of archiving your messages automatically, especially when you are replying to a message, is to turn on the send and archive feature. Here I'm about to reply to this particular message, and I don't want to have to send it first and then hit archive in 2 different steps. I want to archive it immediately. Now, if you don't see this send plus archive as a part of your button, all you need to do is come up to settings, select see all settings, and within the first general tab, you will see that there is a send and archive feature. I would recommend that you turn this on, show send and archive, so you can take advantage of this automatic inbox cleaning step. Now, the next tip for keeping your email decluttered is by bringing in some additional help. And for this, we are going to be using an extension called Samebox. Samebox is one of my favorite tools for keeping my inbox clean because it does things in the background that I could never do on my own. In particular, Samebox has a feature called Email Deep Clean, which you can use absolutely for free. Email Deep Clean automatically rounds up your old, unimportant emails and lets you quickly delete them so you can get to inbox zero sooner. And yes, you can do this absolutely for free. Just go to sanebox.com/simpletivity or click the link in the description and you can use all of the features of Samebox. And a bonus, you'll get a $25 credit towards a Samebox subscription. Once again, go to sanebox.com/simpletivity or click the link down below. Now, while all of my tips so far have involved using a particular feature or turning on a particular setting, my next tip has to do with actually scheduling email as a part of your day. And for that, I want to show you my daily calendar. And you'll notice that there are 2 things that I have scheduled every single workday, one at the beginning and one near the end of my day. I do my very best to deal with email and spend time with my inbox only twice per day. First, at the very beginning of my day, I will spend a maximum, not always a full hour, but up to a maximum with email and other smaller admin tasks. And then I will focus the rest of my day on my number one goal and the other things that I want to accomplish. Then at the very end of my day, I will return and do some other smaller administrative tasks and return to my inbox and determine what do I need to reply to or respond to before the end of my day. Now, of course, I don't give myself a limit as to when I can send a message. Depending on the projects and the tasks that I'm working with, I can, of course, send an email whenever I need to. but to the best of my ability, I will only read or reply to messages at the very beginning and the very end of my day. Now, for you, you may have to adjust your schedule accordingly, but at the very least, I ask you to consider creating a schedule, something like this, or something that will work better for you. Now, the next tip on our list has to do with getting another Google app involved. But don't worry, even if you're not using Google Tasks to manage your to-dos, you may want to take advantage of this tip. Let's say I've opened up this message here and I want to be able to respond to this, but I just don't want to do it right now. I'd rather keep going through and reading my other messages before I come back to this one. But how can I keep my inbox clean, uncluttered, and remember to do something with this specific email? Well, at the very top, you will notice that there is a Add to Tasks icon. And if we select this, this is going to immediately open up our task view on the right-hand side, bring in the subject line of that message, which we, of course, can re-edit ourselves. Maybe I'm going to say something like, let's respond to this customer email, something along those lines. But the most important thing here is that it has created a link, a connection to this particular email. Yes, I can add further details if I want. Yes, I can add a due date. Maybe I want to accomplish this before tomorrow. But now I've got a direct link to this email. So no matter where I am within my inbox, I could be in my labels area if I want to. Oh, yeah, I want to respond to this customer email. I can select that link. It's going to bring me directly to this message. You can see I have a couple of other examples here to show you. I want to reply to this comment. Just click on it. It's going to bring me to that message. Click on this message. It's going to bring me directly to this one as well. And once I've hit replied or done whatever I need to with this message, I can check it off of my to-do list. Now, for my final tip, I want to share with you something that has drastically changed the way that I deal with my messages here within Gmail, and that is by taking advantage of some very specific shortcut keys. Now, first things first, you want to make sure that you come up to your gear icon, select See All Settings, and then we want to scroll down a little bit and make sure that you have keyboard shortcuts turned on. About halfway down the General tab, you can see that there's a section called Keyboard Shortcuts, and make sure that you select this option. Otherwise, these keyboard shortcuts are not going to work within your Gmail account. Now, the first one here is to take advantage of archiving messages very, very quickly. And to do that, we want to use the E key on our keyboard. So maybe I've read this message, I'm going to hit E, it's gone. I've read this message, I'm done with it, hit E, it's gone. But the next four shortcuts may be even more helpful as a part of your workflow. I hate having to scroll down to the bottom and select this reply button, or again, coming over here and finding the reply button. What if I just hit the letter R on my keyboard? That's right, wherever you are within a message, all you need to do is select R on your keyboard, and then your cursor is waiting for you to type in. If you want to reply all, just select A as in all on your keyboard, and that will bring everyone into the conversation. And what if you want to forward? Yeah, you've probably guessed it. If you hit F, this will bring up the forward option so you can forward this message to someone else. But what if you're here within your inbox or somewhere outside of a message and you want to compose something new? Well, stop dragging your cursor all the way up here to the top left-hand corner. Simply select C on your keyboard and that will bring up a brand new message so you can get going and start to craft that new message. So now that you know these seven tips for keeping a cleaner inbox, which was your favorite, or what other questions do you have? Be sure to let me know in the comments down below. Thank you so much for watching today's video, and remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.